Hey guys, what is going on? It's Drevin here, and today I'm back with a TS2 commentary. And today I'm going to be talking about competition and being competitive. And I just want to say before this video starts, no, this video is not going to be about the TF2 competitive scene or anything like that. There's plenty of videos talking about that, so do not whine in the comments that, oh, I've misled you with the title, okay? You got that? Capiche? Alright. Cool. So anyway, as human beings, we are very competitive creatures just by nature. Obviously, some people more so than others, but even saying that, everyone has been competitive throughout their life at least once. The simplest example is when you're a kid and you're playing a game with your friend and you don't want to lose. Because winning is actually a feeling which is indescribable. It's an amazing feeling to win. Now, some people would say that being competitive is a bad thing, and whilst I do like to disagree with this, in some cases they are right. There's times where people are competitive about things which they don't need to be competitive about, such as who's taller than who. I mean, that's something you actually completely can't control. You cannot control how short or tall you are, you just are that way. I mean, unless you want to wear stilts for the rest of your life and look like a complete colossal tit, then be my guest. But an area where I do think it is healthy to be competitive is with something that you are very interested in and passionate about, and something that you're good at. This is your field, this is your turf. And this can either be a career, a sport, hell, even a hobby that you're looking to take to the next level. In order to get yourself to that next level, you got to come up against people who are either better than you or are a similar sort of ability set to you, because you can learn from these people and you can get skills to take you up to that next level. Because I tell you what, if you spend your whole life going up against people who are just terrible and not even close to your level, then how are you supposed to evolve? You're just going to stay in the same place, you're just going to be spinning your tires in the sand, not getting anywhere. Now I'm going to tell you a bit of a story, so you may want to go and cue yourself in for this one. I don't know, go and start having a shit on the toilet. That's what I usually do when I'm watching YouTube videos. Don't know about you. So yeah, but a couple of months back I joined the BFI Academy, and upon joining the academy you get to go on a 10-week course, which you'll get taught skills from industry professionals, and at the end of the course, you will make a big short film with a full crew, everything that's going to give you the full professional on-set experience. So when it actually came to getting roles for the film, you didn't get to choose amongst yourselves, you had to pitch why you deserved this role to the industry professionals. And by no surprise, nearly everybody wanted the director role, because being director is great, because you get to have your vision come to life, not anyone else's, yours. And it's selfish saying that, but at the end of the day, it is very true, even though it's a team effort. But as I was saying, we had to pitch for these roles, and there was about 10 people who wanted this role. And not sound arrogant, but I knew I could beat the majority of these people. But there was just one guy, this one dude, who was standing in my way to get in this role, because he was confident, he could talk, and he had great vision. So I knew I had to bring my A-game along to this pitch, and I had never felt this pure feeling of competition before in my life. Because for most of my filmmaking life, a lot of the people I come across really didn't know any better. They just sort of started, and I started making films since the age of 10, so I'd already had a bit more time than them to develop. So when it came to getting roles, I just naturally assumed the leader's position, and this isn't because these people are bad or anything, not at all. It's because they just didn't possess the confidence to lead the team and they needed a bit more time to develop. And I just want to apologise that I sound like one of those douchebags from The Apprentice. So going back to the pitch, I was very well prepared for it. I had notes, I'd rehearsed out the pitch in my head multiple times, because I didn't want to be just one of those people who read off of a piece of paper and go, I want to have the director's role because it is fun and I enjoy it. You know, I wanted to have some proper passion behind my speech. I wanted this pitch to be something that everyone was going to remember. And I was like a WWE wrestler cutting a promo on my audience because I wanted this role. I was hungry for it. And because that element of competition was there, it actually really lit a fire underneath my ass. And when I want something, I tell you what, I get my teeth stuck right in and I make sure that I damn well get it. And you know what? In the end, funny enough, I got it. And if you're wondering what happened to the guy I was up against, he got the assistant director's role, which is still pretty high up anyway, that's just one below the director. And I got to work with him, we made a great team, he was very good at his job, and we made a film I was really proud of. So what I took back from that whole pitching process is that preparation is key. You got to be prepared for stuff, and it's really helped me with doing my YouTube videos whenever I'm doing a commentary and how to structure out a commentary. You know, when I do a commentary, I don't do it just off the cuff anymore. I'll have like little mental notes to read off so I can get to their next point and not lose my train of thought. Now, just because I had won that battle does not mean I'm sorted for life by any means. It doesn't mean that I'm plain sailing, because I tell you what, things are just getting started. I mean, there's going to be times later in my adult life where I'm going to have to pitch for budget, I'm going to have to pitch for scripts, I'm going to have to pitch for roles again. I mean, the filmmaking industry is an extremely competitive one. And there will be times where I will lose, but that's completely okay with me because you can learn from your mistakes. I mean, there's some people who lose and they just give up. I don't get it. You know, if you lose, you learn from that mistake and you get better. So never ever be afraid to fail. And on that note, I think I'm going to end this commentary. For watching, have a nice day, and of course, goodbye.